আমি কোন কুল হতে কোন কুল যাই কাহারে সুধাই রে আমি কাহারে সুধাই রে নদীর কুল না
রিভার দ্যাট ওয়ার্ড has little sense when we use it in South Asia. The South Asian word comes from Sanskrit, which is nodi. It means blood flow in your body, and it talks about three things. It talks about atta, the soul, the pran, the life, and shakti, the power.
আর বিষম নদীর পানি ঢেউয়ে করে হানাহানি মাঙ্গায়ে তরুণী তবু বায়োরে.
Why the rivers in South Asia are named after gods and goddesses? Because these are gods and goddesses to South Asia, and that gives you a totally different meaning when in South Asia, when you are looking at river, because then you know that you can't kill it, you can't block it, you have to treat it as life.
Ten major rivers of Asia emerge from the Himalaya, and they have sustained several important civilizations for 1,000 years. Being 8 kilometers tall, unconsolidated, young, geologically fragile mountain, the level of sediment generation is much higher. The energy which the mountain rivers carry is very, very large. If you touch the energy part, the sediment part will be impacted. If the sediment part is impacted, the biodiversity will be changed. So this complex combination is to be kept in mind about the characteristics of Himalayan rivers. Three rivers are vital for South Asia. Yarlung Zangpo originates at the Angsi Glacier near Mount Kailash in Tibet, flows eastward and takes almost an U-turn and moves towards India. And from India, where numerous other tributaries, they join the Brahmaputra, and it goes all the way up to Dhubri. When it enters Bangladesh, we get a new name called Jamuna. Indus flows westwards in Tibet, and it crosses into the Indian state of Jammu and Kashmir briefly, then into Pakistan. It has revolutionized agriculture in Pakistan. From the Gomukh to Sundarbans, Ganga is an ideal case of learning about transboundary challenges, use of hydrodiplomacy in the management of the transboundary relations. Much of the water that India gets in Ganga comes through Nepal. And we have Kosi, we have Gandak, we have Ghagra or Karnali, and we have Mahakali. These are the four major rivers feeding the Ganga. So transboundary nature of Ganga starts from Nepal-India part quite significantly.
Coming to northern Bihar, the region used to witness floods, and as it's a natural phenomenon and people used to live with floods for centuries together, but somehow the whole concept of protecting civil properties, the whole concept of looking at rivers and floods as disasters that evolved, that rivers have to be tamed, floods have to be controlled.
ये इलाका कोसी का इलाका है, जो लोग कहते हैं ना नदी सहजीवन, नदियों के साथ जीने के लोग अभ्यस्त थे इस इलाके में. बाढ़ आती थी, लोगों को पता होता था कि इस समय बाढ़ आएगी, एक दो महीने रहेगी, और चूंकि उस समय जब बाढ़ आती थी तो पसरा हुआ पानी आता था, तो नुकसान कम होता था और उस पानी के साथ जो गाद साद और मिट्टी आती थी वो मिट्टी हमारे खेतों में फैल जाती थी और उस मिट्टी की वजह से जो यहाँ पैदावार होती थी खास करके धान की पैदावार वो भयानक होती थी और हम दूसरे क्षेत्रों में इस इलाके से अपना चावल निर्यात करते थे। हमारा जीवन जो है बहुत ही सुखमय था, हमें रोजी रोटी के लिए बाहर नहीं जाना पड़ता था। जो विकास का मंदिर खड़ा किया गया इस कोसी क्षेत्र में, जो दोनों ओर तटबंध बनाए गए, कोसी बराज बनाए गए, नहरें बनाई गई और आज यही तटबंध, वही नहर, वही विद्युत परियोजना हमारी समस्या बन गई है। तो कैद कर दिया है कोसी को। नदी 14-15 किलोमीटर जिसका पेट था उसको 1.5 किलोमीटर करने के लिए तटबंध पे तटबंध, अब इधर से ये तटबंध आ रही है, उधर से वो तटबंध है, बीच में फिर ये सड़क है, वर्षा का जल पानी कहाँ जाएगा? उसका इंजीनियरिंग फेल है। अभी आप जहाँ हम खड़े हैं ये तो तटबंध का, अब आप देखें, आप जल जमाव तो है ही, आप देख रहे हैं कि इधर नीचे जल जमाव है, तटबंध के किनारे वैसे ही विस्थापित लोग हैं, विकास के नाम पर हाईवे बने हैं। अब ये राजमार्ग तो बनी, कहीं उसमें जल निकासी का व्यवस्था नहीं किया गया है और वर्षा का पानी डंप करने से और इस जल जमाव के कारण जो अंदर का जो पानी है वो खराब हो, दूषित हो गया है। हम लोग चापाकल का पानी ये मान करके पीते हैं कि बहुत शुद्ध पानी पी रहे हैं, लेकिन उस पानी में जो आर्सेनिक है, फ्लोराइड है, आयरन है, उसकी वजह से विभिन्न जल जनित बीमारियां हो रही है।
मैया भीख मांगे नूर बटे कोसी में घर हमर भैस गल
So eventually what has happened in the last 60 years, you keep on building embankments, repairing embankments after they breach, but you do not see a long-term solution to it or bring in other players. If you bring community who is seeing it every day that it is eroding, it's far easier to do the damage control. Panda used to come from the Someshwar hills since ancient times. There are Tharu communities and other indigenous tribes living around it. Some 10 years back, people witnessed that the river, which is not actually a perennial river, it's a snow-fed river, the supply is diminishing. That Nepal-India mindset that, you know, the big country and the small country and villages in Nepal do not easily are convinced to talk to villages in India. It took some years. Few committed people in both sides took the lead and they sat together to find a solution, and people thought that instead of one stream, if the river is divided into three, and they, interestingly, they do not cut the flow of the river. They allow it to flow, but they then divert its flow in a way where two streams go to Nepal and one comes down to India.
त लोकल लेभलमा के भयो भने चाहिँ हामीलाई पानी चाहियो भने ल सम्झौता गर्यो, लोकल लेभलमा सम्झौता गरेर हामीले चाहिँ कोही भारत सरकारले कोही मान्डी पास गरेर कुनै नेपाल इन्डियन सरकारलाई दिनुपर्छ भनेर हामीले चाहिँ यहाँ ग्यारेन्टी लिएको छैन। तर यो लोकल लेभलमा भाइचारामा हामी पठाइरहेको छौँ पानी भारतमा, एउटा नेपालको नेपाल र भारतको चाहिँ एउटा चाहिँ नौ और मासुको सम्बन्ध छ, भाइ बहिनको रिस्ता छ, रोटी और बेटीको रिस्ता छ। यहाँ
इतना ही नहीं, हम लोग एक ऐसी काम करें कि जो दोनों देश के लोग आपस में, सरकार करे विकास न करे, लेकिन हम लोग अगर दोनों देश के लोग आपसी में अब राय मसौदा से रहें और राय मसौदा से काम करें तो हम लोगों का माने विकास सरकार करे न करे अपने आप हो जाएगा।
द एंटायर वाटर गवर्नेंस स्ट्रक्चर राइट फ्रॉम टेक टॉप टू बॉटम अप्रोच आइदर एट द ट्रांसबाउंड्री लेवल और द स्टेट लेवल, there is no space for communities anywhere to raise their voice. We have really not creatively utilized panchayati raj institutions. we have not really looked into whether these powers can be expanded to give communities control over rivers, because they are the actual conservators, managers of these systems.
How much water does the river need? It's a some kind of a multi-level game in terms of hydropolitics. On the one hand, you have a conflict between sectors. Around 85% of the water is going for agriculture. So if I club this as the economic sector, then you have the other element as the environment sector. The environment has its water needs, something that you are calling e-flows. This is a very, very important thing that one has to remember if you at all have to think of an e-flow regime, that it has to mimic the natural flow regime. If you look at the Sundarbans and the drying Sundarbans delta, there has been a stream flow depletion. There has been sedimentation across these channels. And let's see the other pressure point of the Sundarbans, sea level rise. When the freshwater flow has declined to the delta and the sea level is rising, naturally the saline water takes up the space of the freshwater. And we have found that almost 40% of the Sundarbans is lost.
Sundarban is the last mile connectivity between India and Bangladesh for river route. So naturally you have to keep Sundarban open. When you ply through India to Bangladesh to Assam, you first ply through the Sundarban waterways, then you come to Meghna, then you come to Jamuna, then you go to Brahmaputra. So actually you are traveling through five rivers. So as on date also, possibly inland waterways is the only mode of transport between the two countries. So Government of India fortunately has now taken up the work of developing River Brahmaputra as national waterway number 2. Similarly, the Bangladesh government is also taking up improvement of their rivers for connectivity through to India and all. Everything in Bangladesh moves through river. If you travel to Bangladesh waters, you'll find that compared to us, their movement through river is 100 times.
When you go to Buri Ganga and some of the rivers, you do get a sense it is very lively and it's a living kind of thing, because a lot of trade, a lot of people move. We have a saying in Bengali, Nodi Matrik Desh, and that tells you that it is a country which is Nodi centric.
The Meghna and Padma, so when they mix together, they create this harmony. The harmony of two rivers that you see here are essentially coming together. These are the two different livelihoods projecting the unity of two different rivers in Bangladesh. These two rivers are the backbones that shows that transboundary water needs to be managed properly. Padma's Ilish is one of the fundamental driving factor that keeps the bonding alive. So therefore, I think Ilish shall be considered as one of the integral component for Bangladesh and India to cooperate and think about how we manage our water relationship in the coming decade.
The bans, the different periods have happened in Bangladesh, and it's increased the production about 5 to 6 times. This year, Ilish has been found on both sides of the border, on the Tista and the Brahmaputra. This was available 15 to 20 years ago. Imagine the joy in both the countries. Also, we should have to understand that Ilish is not just about, you know, the ban and the conservation. It should also be about river management, pollution, navigation. These are also impacting the habitats of the Ilish. How to integrate that into the planning and conversation of Ilish, that needs to be brought into.
I'm sure the future is much more brighter than the past. The reason is we now have more science, as well as we have more technologies in our hand. And obviously what we need is more sanity when we deal with the issues related to water. So therefore, only challenge that I see that how we use these technologies and the information that we have.
The stakeholders look at rivers, which are source of water, which is our lifeline, from their own perspective, which is largely need-driven. IUCN has that unique ability to bring different stakeholders on one platform. We are bringing the civil society groups, government agencies, scientists, technical persons, and we discuss the perspectives of different stakeholders and try to find the gaps and enter into constructive dialogue. Based on that, develop learning module for the present and the future professionals so that they can enter into cooperative management of the water resources.
Very easy to be a Bangladeshi, very easy to be an Indian, very easy to be a Nepali, but very difficult to be a South Asian. Water cannot be nationalized in any way. So the very fact that we have ended up territorializing, and this is where nationalism becomes an issue, which runs counter to nature, to human life. Rivers ought to be treated as nodi, as life, akta and shakti. If that is done, connectivity would increase much more than what it is now.
আমারহ কুলের কুল দয়াল আল্লাহর যদি দেখা পাই রে নদীর কুল নাই কিনার নাই রে আমি কোন কুল হতে কোন কুলে যাই কাহারে সুধাই রে আমি কাহারে সুধাই রে নদীর কুল নাই কিনার নাই রে